around the world with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, Chief Medical Correspondent. It's so interesting because our brains are in three dimensions. Our brains have feeling to them, yet when we look at pictures of the brains and we see our patients with multiple sclerosis, we look at MRIs and we generally look in two dimensions. So for the first time, scientists at UT Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas, Texas, have actually taken this idea of a two-dimensional lesion and printed it on a 3D printer and actually allowed us to actually see what MS lesions look like, and then to compare those lesions, to hold them in their hands and compare them to lesions that we don't think are from multiple sclerosis. That's why I'm so happy to be joined here by a great colleague of mine, by Dr. Darin Okuda, who is an associate professor of neurology at UT Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas, Texas, as well as Braeden Newton, who is a research associate who is going to be going, hopefully, to medical school at one day might be a doctor near you.
So we actually found that MS lesions themselves really aren't ovoid in shape, and that they have very, very dynamic characteristics to them. So we actually believe now MS lesions are amorphous with very complex surface morphologies. And so the old convention is that an MS lesion has this given egg-like shape, and the term ovoid really implies some degree of symmetry. Our findings show that MS lesions themselves tend to be more asymmetric. And not only that, they also tend to have more complex features, meaning that their surfaces are much more dynamic than what we once thought.
Braeden, when you were doing this, how did you get a three-dimensional picture? Because when I show my patients MRIs, it looks like it's in two dimensions. They don't see a three dimension. You use some technology that's been kind of hot on the press lately, which is a 3D printer. Can you tell us more about that, please?
Yeah, so it was a long process, long and arduous, but we were managed to, using Osirix, to take a 2D or a 3D flare, take it from an axial MRI and generate it in an MIP, maximum intensity projection view, which gave us a 3D brain that we could manipulate in all directions, you know, go through, zoom in, and using that we were able to isolate lesions and manually 3D print them, and the value in the 3D printing was being able to hold them in your hand and really appreciate the depth and complexity of the lesions.
So what you actually did is you took an MRI image, then what you did is you took an image called a flare, or fluid attenuated inversion recovery, which is kind of like, you may have heard of T2 lesions. So flare is like T2, but we suck out the fluid so it makes those white spots appear brighter. And then you did it three-dimensional, and then you simply print it out on a three-dimensional printer. And then holding it in your hand is actually how you guys were able to make descriptions and find that these lesions weren't just as simple as we had thought. These symbols were actually a lot more complex, as opposed to what we call non-specific lesions. And what that means is that not every white spot that a doctor sees on an MRI is actually multiple sclerosis. There are white spots that come from age, there are white spots that come from migraine. Just like you have dots in your hands, you may have white spots on your brain as well. And even a person with MS may have some lesions that are more from their MS and more that are what we call non-specific.
In this panel, you see a patient with multiple sclerosis. There's a lesion that's circled. We then focus in on that specific lesion, and we're able to appreciate the lesion in orthographic view. So we're able to manipulate its 3D form on a computer screen. From there, we're able to print out the lesion itself. And what we find is that multiple sclerosis lesions are very asymmetric in comparison to a patient that has a non-specific lesion within the brain. And there tends to be more symmetry in those patients with non-specific white matter disease. We also identified that in those patients afflicted with MS, that their lesions were much more dynamic with respect to surface characteristics. So the surface appears much more complex as compared to a patient with non-specific white matter disease, whereby the surface itself is very smooth and lacks additional character. So not only are MS lesions asymmetric, they also tend to be very complex with respect to their surface character. There are secondary characteristics associated with multiple sclerosis. Many multiple sclerosis lesions are actually multilobular in shape. They can be elongated, where there's irregular mass distribution across the lesion. lesions may be associated with protrusions as well as slopes. And these secondary characteristics were observed to be very common within our MS group and very different than lesions that typically came from a group of patients with non-specific white matter disease. They had lesions that were very symmetric and lesions that had smooth surfaces.
So Dr. Okuda, what I want to know is, how do we take this from just somebody printing them out on a three-dimensional printer to actually using it in a clinic? Do you think it's something that we can actually do in the future?
So that's a fantastic question. So the answer is yes. And MS lesions themselves not just have, they tend to have more than just primary or differences in primary characteristics. They also tend to be lesions that have these secondary traits. So they tend to be more multilobular. They may have a given protrusion. They may be associated with a given sloped edge, or they may be elongated with irregular mass distribution. And so taking it further, we hope to now incorporate some machine learning, which will then allow for these quantitative techniques to be used that will allow for the study of different parts of a given lesion. So we can study regions of interest within a region of interest, and then through complicated mathematics, be able to predict whether a new lesion that we identify on MRI scans, if that lesion is truly due to multiple sclerosis or if it's due to a non-specific white matter lesion.
Well, Dr. Okuda and Braeden Newton, thank you so much for joining us. And for everyone back home, this is something we're going to see in the future. So you can't go out to your neurologist right now or your radiologist locally and ask them to do this sort of analysis. But this is going to help us to better understand multiple sclerosis. And the more we understand the multiple sclerosis aspects, the better we can treat it in the future. I want to thank you so much for joining us at home.